Swam happily. It just so happened that a curious monkey had been watching all this from a branch of a nearby tree. Peering between the green leaves, she had paid very close attention. When she had caught sight of the most precious pearl necklace, her eyes had nearly popped out of her head.
Beautiful necklace. It's sparkling. I will look more beautiful with this necklace.
Imagining how grand she would look wearing the queen's beautiful necklace, she patiently watched the servant girl who was guarding it. At first, the girl watched over it very carefully. But the heat of the day soon made her drowsy. When the monkey saw her start to snooze, she swung down from the tree as fast as the wind. In a flash, she grabbed the necklace most precious, put it around her neck, and ran back up the tree. Afraid that the other monkeys would see it, the little queen hid the green pearl necklace in the hollow of the tree. Then she sang, guarding the book, remaining silent and pretending to be silent. In a minute or two, the servant girl awoke from her accidental nap. Frightened, she immediately looked at the queen's possession. When she saw the necklace was missing, she yelled out in terror,
"Help! Help! Somebody has taken the queen's pearl necklace! The one called most precious! Help!"
"Stop all of you! Guards, stop everyone! No one should move!"
"Oh God, that is my favorite necklace!"
"Don't panic, you will get the necklace."
Frightened of the king's wrath, the guards began dashing madly around the pleasure garden, searching for the thief. At that very moment, there happened to be a poor man walking just outside the garden. He was on his way back to his far-off village after paying his meager taxes to the royal treasury. The commotion from inside the park scared him, and he started running away. Unfortunately, the security guards saw him run.
"He must be the thief."
They rushed through the garden gate and, after a short chase, easily captured the innocent man. They began to beat him.
"You no good thief. Confess that you robbed the queen's pearl necklace. How dare you do this?"
"If I say I didn't take it, they will be beat me to the death for sure. But if I confess, they will have to take me to the king. Yes, I admit, I took the necklace."
Hearing this, the security guards handcuffed him and hauled him off to the king. When told of the man's confession, the king became wild.
"Where is the most precious necklace now? What have you done with it?"
"My lord, I am a very poor man indeed. I have never in my life owned anything at all valuable. Not a most precious bed or most precious chair. And certainly not a most precious pearl necklace. It was Your Majesty's own chief financial advisor who made me steal this most precious. I gave it to him. He alone knows where it is now.
King Brahmadatta summoned his chief financial advisor.
Did you take most precious from this man's hands?
Yes, my lord.
Where is it now?
I gave it to the royal teacher priest.
The royal teacher priest was called for and asked about the stolen necklace.
I gave it to the official court musician.
He in turn was summoned and questioned. He answered, I gave the most precious to a dancer. When she was identified and brought to the king, he demanded to know what she had done with the queen's pearl necklace.
Your Majesty, I don't know anything about the pearl necklace.
As the sun began to set,
let us continue the investigation tomorrow.
He handed the five suspects over to his ministers and returned to his palace for the night. Meanwhile, the royal minister, who was along with the king, had seen and heard all that had taken place in the pleasure garden. He realized that the mystery could be solved only by careful examination. Jumping to conclusions could lead to wrong answers. So he started examining and analyzing the situation in his mind.
My lord, the necklace was lost inside the pleasure garden, but the poor villager was captured outside the pleasure garden. The gates had hefty guards standing watch. Therefore, the villager could not have come in to steal the necklace.
True.
Likewise, no one from inside the garden could have gotten out through the guarded gates with the stolen necklace. So it can be seen that none of these people could have gotten away with most precious either from inside or outside.
But how come a group of people are involved in this?
What a mystery. The poor man who was first accused must have said he gave it to the chief financial advisor just to save himself. The chief financial advisor must have thought it would be easier for him if the royal teacher priest was involved. The priest must have blamed the official court musician so that music would make their time in the palace dungeon pass more pleasantly. And the official court musician probably thought that being with the dancer would take away the misery of prison life. So he has said that he gave the necklace to her.
After examining things carefully, it is easy to see that all five suspects are innocent.
But the garden is full of monkeys who are known to cause mischief. No doubt, some she-monkey thought most precious would set her above the rest, and the necklace is still in her hands.
Don't blabber, the monkeys are not that bold.
Your Excellency, if you hand over the suspects to me, I will do the investigation for you.
By all means, Minister, examine the suspects yourself.
The minister called for his servant boys. He told them to keep the five suspects together in one place. They were to hide nearby, listen to all that was said, and then report back to him. When the five prisoners thought they were alone, they began talking freely to each other. First, the chief financial advisor said to the poor villager,
"You little crook, we never saw each other before. So when did you give most precious to me?"
"My lord, sir, most exalted advisor to the great king, I have never had anything of any value whatsoever, not even a broken down bed or chair. I certainly have not seen any such most precious necklace."
"Then why did you accept the charge that you had stolen it?"
"I don't know what your people are talking about, being scared to the death by the king's guard. I only mention you in the hope that one as important as you could free us both. Please, my lord, don't be angry at me."
The royal teacher priest said to the chief financial advisor,
"You see, this man admits he has not given it to you. So how could you have given it to me?"
"We both are in high positions. I thought that if we got together and backed each other up, we could settle this matter."
"Oh, royal teacher priest, when did you give the queen's pearl necklace to me?"
"I thought that if you were imprisoned with me, your music would make it much more pleasant. That's why I lied."
"You miserable crook! When did I see you? When did you see me? We have never met each other before. So when could you possibly have given me the stolen most precious?"
"Oh dear young lady, please don't be angry with me. I only accused you so that when we are in prison together, your being with us will make us all happy."
Not being either a poor frightened stranger or an obliging government official, the dancer was the only one who had told the truth. So there was no one to accuse her of shifting the blame. Of course, the wise minister's servants had been eavesdropping on the entire conversation. When they reported it all back to him, he realized his suspicion was confirmed. Some she monkey must have taken the necklace.
"I must come up with a plan to get it back. Guards, arrange for some imitation jewels faster."
First, he had a bunch of cheap imitation jewel ornaments made. Then he had several she monkeys captured in the royal pleasure garden. He had them decorated with the cheap sparkling necklaces on their necks and bracelets on their wrists and ankles. Then they were released in the garden. The minister ordered his servants to watch all the she monkeys carefully. When they saw the monkey with the missing pearl necklace. They were to scare her into dropping it. The she-monkey who had taken most precious was still guarding it in the hollow of the tree. The other she-monkeys strutted back.
See how fine we look. We have these beautiful necklaces and bracelets.
She cannot bear it to see us wearing these necklaces.
Those are nothing but worthless imitations. I will show them what I have.
To show them all up, she put on her own neck the most precious necklace of real pearls. Immediately, the servants frightened her into dropping it.